Welcome to the Machine Learning Essentials series. In this video, we're going to create a deep learning model with PyTorch. Now, if you don't know, PyTorch is an open source machine learning framework that accelerates the path from research prototyping to production deployment. It also happens to be one of my favorite deep learning libraries because it has a powerful tensor library, auto-differentiable computational graph, and built-in data structures for managing data, models, and optimization. In this video, we'll be solving a simple image classification problem to illustrate how PyTorch is used. In my case, since I love tacos and burritos, I'm going to make the model distinguish between the two. All right, obviously, we need to start with data. The main classes for dealing with data are datasets, transformations, and data loaders. Datasets model collections of data that are used to train a model. Inside of these datasets, we add transformations so that the images as they come in can be transformed into a shape that the model will understand. Data loaders help in loading, batching, and transforming the data as an input to the model. Like I said before, in this case, we will be reading images from disks, so we will use a basic image folder dataset and a standard data loader. You can see them all right here. We have one training dataset, one training data loader, and some transformations for the training, as well as the same for validation. All right, let's talk about my favorite part, models. Models can be built in several ways. You can subclass nn.module to encapsulate the whole thing, or you can write them directly in line using nn sequential. Both work really well. In our case, we will use a simple inline model that uses MobileNet V2, a well-known model that has already been trained. And the power of this is we can use the model parameters that have already been learned in other scenarios. This is called transfer learning. Once a model is selected, we need to choose a loss function and an optimizer we can use to learn the appropriate model parameters. Think of the loss function as a way of measuring how bad the model is at it, and think of the optimizer as a hammer that lessens the amount of loss that we have. Here, we will choose the cross-entropy loss, and we'll use standard stochastic gradient descent as the optimizer. Now, if you don't know what those are, remember, the loss function measures how bad we are at it, and the optimizer makes the badness go down. Now, we loop the data until we minimize the loss and maximize the accuracy. Now, running this locally is great, but it is hard to share and save the work. Azure Machine Learning is a great way to move a local machine learning run directly into the cloud. To run this experiment, there are three basic concepts we need to sort out in the cloud. The first is storage, the second is the environment, and the last is the compute. Let's talk about the thing that unifies these all together. The Azure Machine Learning Workspace is the top-level resource for Azure Machine Learning, providing a centralized place to work with all of the artifacts you create when you use Azure Machine Learning. The workspace keeps a history of all training runs, including logs, metrics, output, and a snapshot of your scripts. You use this information to determine which training run produces the best model. And it also stores where your data is, where your environments are, and where your compute is. Let's start with data. Azure Machine Learning makes it easy to connect to your data in the cloud. It provides an abstraction layer over the underlying storage service, so you can securely access and work with your data without having to write code specific to your storage type. Azure Machine Learning also provides a number of amazing data capabilities, such as interoperability with pandas and Spark data frames, versioning and tracking of data lineage, data labeling, and data drift monitoring. Now, the way it does this is through two interesting data concepts. The first is the data store, and the second is the data set. Think of the data store as the hard drive and the data set as the versionable view into your hard drive. Let's start with a data store. Azure Machine Learning data stores securely keep the connection information to your Azure storage, so you don't have to code it into your scripts. You can register and create a data store to easily connect to your storage account and access the data in your underlying Azure storage service. Now let's talk about data sets. Azure Machine Learning data sets aren't copies of your data. By creating a data set, you create a reference to the data in its storage service along with a copy of its metadata. Because data sets are lazily evaluated and the data remains in its existing location, you incur no extra cost. To interact with your data in storage, create a data set to package your data into a consumable object for machine learning tasks. You can also register the data set to your workspace to share and reuse it across different experiments without data ingestion complexities. And the best part is that these things are versionable. So you can have multiple versions of a data set to even trace a model all the way to the data that generated it. All right, we've just talked about storage. All we have left are environments and compute. Azure machine learning environments are an encapsulation of the environment where your machine learning training actually happens. They specify the Python packages, environment variables, and software settings around your training and scoring scripts. They also specify the runtimes. In our case, you can run Python, Spark, or Docker. These environments are managed and versioned entities within your machine learning workspace that enable reproducible, auditable, and portable machine learning workflows across a variety of compute targets. You can use these environment objects on your local compute to develop your training script, and you can reuse the same environment on Azure Machine Learning Compute for model training at scale. You can also deploy your model with that same environment. And you can revisit the environment in which an existing model was trained. This is amazing. We no longer have the excuse that it ran on my computer. So we talked about storage, we talked about environments, now let's talk about compute. For compute, there are some amazing options. An Azure Machine Learning Compute instance is a managed cloud-based workstation for data scientists. Compute instances make it easy to get started with Azure machine learning development, as well as provide management and enterprise readiness capabilities for IT administrators. You can use a compute instance as your fully configured and management development environment in the cloud for machine learning. They can also be used as a compute target for training and inferencing for development and testing purposes. For production-grade model training, though, you should use an Azure machine learning compute cluster with multi-node scaling capabilities. And for production-grade model deployment, you can use an Azure Kubernetes service cluster. All right, so how do we use these? A compute target is a designated compute resource or environment where you can run your training script or host your service deployment. This location might be your local machine or a cloud-based compute resource. Using compute targets makes it easy for you to later change your compute environment without having to change your code at all. In a typical model development lifecycle, you might start by developing and experimenting on a small amount of data. At this stage, you use your local environment, such as local compute or compute instance, as your compute target. Then you can scale up to larger data or do distributed training by using one of our compute clusters as a compute target. After your model is ready, you can deploy it to a web hosting environment or IoT device with one of these deployment compute targets as well. The compute resources you use for your compute targets are literally attached to the workspace. Compute resources other than the local machine are also shared by everyone in the workspace. All right, we've done the storage, we've done the environments, we've done the compute. Now let's get to work. Azure Machine Learning provides several ways to train your models, from code-first solutions using the SDK to low-code solutions such as Automin Machine Learning and the Visual Designer. A typical way to train models is to use a training script and run configuration. The run configuration provides the information needed to configure the training environment used to train your model. You can specify your training script, compute target, and Azure machine learning environment in your run configuration and run a training job. That's exactly what we do for our tacos and burritos. The best thing about running these experiments in Azure machine learning is how it stores everything related to the run. This includes log metrics, images produced, outputs, logs, and much, much more. This is incredibly powerful when working with others, as well as providing transparency for every single model that you build. Now, machine learning models are the primary output of this whole process. They're basically a file or a set of files, and they should be treated as any other software artifact. Model registration allows you to store and version your models directly in the cloud inside of your Azure machine learning workspace. The model registry makes it easy to organize and keep track of your trained model. A registered model is a logical container for one or more local files that make up your model. For example, if you have a model that is stored in multiple files, you can register them as a single model in your Azure machine learning workspace. After registration, you can then download or deploy the registered model and receive all the files that were registered. Registered models are identified by name and by version. Each time you register a model with the same name as an existing one, the registry increments the version. Additionally, you can add metadata tags that can provide additional information during registration. These tags can then be used when searching for a model. Azure Machine Learning supports any model that can be loaded using Python 3, 5, or higher. In other words, gone are the days where we're emailing model files to each other. We don't have to do it anymore. Now, the best part about models is deploying them. Trained machine learning models can be deployed as web services in the cloud or locally. After all, they're your models. And you can even deploy these models to Azure IoT Edge devices. You can deploy these things using either CPUs or more powerful GPUs for inferencing. You can also use these models directly from Power BI. In order to deploy these models, all you need to do is provide an entry script. The entry script receives data submitted to a deployed web service and passes it to the model. It then takes the response returned by the model and returns that to the client. The script is specific to your model. It must understand the data that the model expects and returns. The two things you need to accomplish this are basically, number one, loading the model in a function called init, and number two, running the model on input data using a function called run. Finally, once the model, the entry script, and the environment are provided, you have a ready-made endpoint for serving with the click of a button. Let's recap. We've learned how to use PyTorch as a deep learning framework to distinguish between tacos and burritos. We also saw how moving that to the cloud was easy with concepts such as storage, environments, and compute, and what they look like in Azure Machine Learning. Finally, we saw how to move a registered model into an endpoint so that anyone could use it. And that's it. The only thing left for you to do is to get started to build your next machine learning model on Azure Machine Learning.